Oklahoma Gas Arena. We have a decided matchup today between two young prospects from the Monroe Farms. And now, the young Kato was a contender. He had the guts, he had the seeds, he had the glory to his name. All of a sudden, against him in all forms and manners of speech and dimensions of space, the contender's challenger, the other guy, and the other guy comes up and he's done all sorts of training. Boy, has he come in, and he's done wicked, wicked push-ups. He can't bend too well. He stays straight. He stays straight in the arm. We're with the green prickly top challenger against the old Wily. He has some battle scars on him. He has some brown bruising showing on his purple skin. And all of a sudden, round one happens. And there they are, closing with each other, bumping a few times. Oh, they're gonna leave some nasty marks right away. And I can tell there's a poke, and a poke comes in, and all of a sudden, one of the guys is on the ground, and the ref comes in, and he's just looking at him, he's salivating, he's thinking about a clay catch door or something like that. But he counts up, and he's up again, and he's swinging, he's coming in, and he's swinging. Well, I remember one time I had dinner with his mama, and I was a friend of Mama's Shotgun Shack, and I was the contender, Jack comes in with a flurry of unexpected sizzling, spicy sizzling, and he's oiled up too. I think they rubbed him down with some nice extra virgin olive oil before he came into the ring. And now, all of a sudden, the challenger's on the ropes. Wait, it's the champion. Now here's the champion. Ooh, the champion's on the ropes. What the hell is going on if he presses those ropes any harder? He's gonna mandolin himself into simple taste. He says, well, wait a minute, no, all of a sudden, wait, what am I seeing here? I think there is us in the round one. Here comes the referee. The referee is going to make some sort of announcement here.
Ladies, and gentlemen, I would like to remind you of the Jimmy Hunt, fun, being testimony, can't. And now, round two.
And here comes the bell for round two. And they've been towel off. After they've been towel off by their support team, they're looking at the corners, they're just staring at each other. These two warriors have been through one hell of a round one. I'm not sure what they want to do now. They're still bumping into each other a little more. I'm not sure if this is dry humping or if the fight's about to break out. All right, all of a sudden, here comes the champion. And the champion, he has some stones. He has some hard seeds in his corner. And then, wait, in the stands. Is that Dr. Moreau himself? Is he holding some sort of remote control? He's holding a remote control device. And then is he manipulating this Rock'em Sock'em eggplants? Dr. Moreau is holding a remote control device in the stands. He's making one of these plants. Both of them. I can't tell. This is a very confusing skirmish. And an unexpected end to round two when the bell rings early. Well, I guess we aren't going by Queensbury rules anymore. All right, back to their quarters. They're being vaseline in the face. They're having their tops cropped. Is that a peeler I see? Nobody's being peeled just yet. Sometimes you gotta peel when a bruise develops underneath the skin. All right, now all of a sudden, it's the sizzling round three. And in round three, I don't think we can depend on any logical instinct. Time or space. We must suspend all understanding of the universe as we know it. Here they come. That was a slicing blow. I think he has something. Yes, he has a hidden razor in him somewhere. And then the challenger is just filleting. He's filleting the champion. Oh, this is gruesome. This is terrible to see. And the champion has all sorts of raggedy ass, unappealing, unappetizing sort of cuts all over his skin. But wait, there's the champion. All of a sudden, he's using his brute size and force. Ramming into the challenger, who's sort of toppling over. unprofessional, unchef-worthy. Never imagine these six tickets. How much do I think I can see some wobbling? There's wobbling. The champions keep coming. And then the champions keep coming. He just might fall for it. And the champions coming. No. Part of him is still upright. Part of him is hanging in a perpendicular, a most disgusting perpendicular angle. I don't know what to make of it. He looks like he's trying to form some sort of Greek letter. No, but now that the challenger is right about to become the new champion. And he's doing a pummel maneuver, the maneuver which the champion so recently executed upon the challenger. He's getting paid back in spades, and then with that separation and midsection, there's all sorts of disgusting feelings coming up. I've seen scenes of the cat wrestling. That's it, his corner has thrown in the towel. The champion has been defeated. It seems they're all over the canvas, and the ref comes in and he raises the stock of the challenger, who is now the new champion. My God, what pandemonium, what mayhem, what sort of idolatry and bullshit is this? I'm coming to you live from the arena, and I just have nothing further to say.